Tondo. Once the cradle of Filipino heroes during the Philippine Revolution against Spain more than a century ago, is now a district name commonly identified as one of the depressed urban areas in the city of Manila. A large number of Tondo's population, of about 600,000, are migrants from the countrysides and nearby islands, nearly half of them belonging to the urban poor. In detail, almost 50,000 families are the poorest of the poor, almost 6,000 of whom are living in shanties built by the riverbanks under the bridges and on public lands where basic health needs have become a luxury. More than half of the families have no access to garbage and sewage disposal system. They have no toilet facilities to speak of. They live their below poverty line lives in one-room dwellings with a water faucet they share with countless others. The vacant lots and available spaces on which the homeless build their makeshift homes have become seedbeds of occupational and contagious diseases. Amidst these stark realities in a depressed urban area such as Tondo, stands the Mary Johnston Hospital, a hospital that for many decades has served as a symbol of hope for the underprivileged sector of the community. True to its mission of providing the best medical services available to the less fortunate among the people of Tondo, the Mary Johnston Hospital admits patients who come to her, regardless of color, creed, religion, or political persuasion, as it did 98 years ago.
It all began here, in a small room of the Bible Training School for Women, converted into a clinic along Rizal Avenue in Santa Cruz, Manila, and became known then as Dispensaria Betania on December 10, 1906. The clinic had Dr. Rebecca Parrish, a missionary doctor from Indiana, USA, and along with her were three young Filipinas, loaned from the Bible school to assist her, and a regular nurse from the USA who arrived the following year. The clinic transferred to its present site in Tondo, Manila in 1908, and the first two-story maternity and children's hospital was erected through a donation of $12,500 by Mr. Daniel S.B. Johnston from St. Paul, Minnesota. It was a memorial to his late missionary wife, Mrs. Mary Johnston. In 1920, a $10,000 contribution from the USA made possible the construction of an additional wing and other facilities, thus converting it to a general hospital.
At the outbreak of the Second World War, casualties from the Japanese bombings of Manila were taken to the Mary Johnston Hospital for treatment, including those from the Cavite Navy Yard. Medicine and food were scarce, and the hospital staff seldom received their pay, yet no one ever complained nor ceased to serve.
During the American forces' liberation of Manila from the Japanese occupation on February 5, 1945, the hospital was razed to the ground and almost everything in it was reduced to ashes. Fortunately, however, All hospital records were saved through the courageous effort of the then nursing services head, Ms. Librada Havalera, who transported them to Cavite before the tragic event. Those valuable records revealed that retired Chief Justice Andres Narvasa, Chief Justice Artemio Panganiban, former Senator Leticia Shahani, Senate President Manuel Villar, and Congressman Jaime Lopez were among those who were born in Mary Johnston Hospital.
And after 5 long years of waiting, the United States of America once again came to its rescue and helped the hospital rise from the ashes. They donated 1,200,000 pesos for the construction of a bigger and more efficient hospital. The cornerstone laying was held on September 3, 1949. The old building's cornerstone was placed in a box and inserted behind the gray marble slab bearing the inscription, Mary Johnston Hospital, 1949. The ceremony was officiated by Bishop Jose L. Valencia, representing the Methodist Church of the Philippines, Dr. Gumercindo Garcia, Sr., Hospital Administrator, Mrs. Mary L. Deem, and Dr. Ernest Tak, representing the two divisions of the missions of the Methodist Church in the USA. On August 26, 1950, the new hospital building was inaugurated by no less than the late Philippine President Elpidio Quirino. As part of his speech, he said, "I wish there were more hospitals in the country that can render as much service as this hospital has rendered." The newly built Mary Johnston Hospital became a general hospital, ministering to men, women, and children. A modern hospital fully equipped with an X-ray department, a laboratory, a complete medical, surgical, obstetrical, and pediatrics departments, and an OPD and public health unit. In 1964, family planning was incorporated into the services of the hospital, an offshoot of its deep concern for the rapid population growth in the Philippines, particularly in Tondo. The Masonic Ward for Crippled Children, which was established way back in September 23, 1925, eventually increased its capacity from 5 to 20 beds. It is the oldest institution aimed at alleviating the problems of crippled children in the Philippines. In its 79 years of existence, it has helped rehabilitate thousands of crippled children. Thus, on November 26, 1987, the Masonic Charities for Crippled Children was the proud recipient of the prestigious Apolinario Mabini Award in the Rehabilitation Volunteer Group category given by the Philippine Foundation for the Rehabilitation of the Disabled. Mary Johnston Hospital has gone a long, long way in serving Tondo's and other outlying towns and cities' medical needs. It will reach its 100th year of dedicated service 2 years from now, in 2006.